Lord, I want to let your praises ring. I will give all of me, Lord, yes, whatever it takes to worship you. We bless your name, God. Yeah. Lord, it's my desire to please you. Yeah. Lay down my will.
I follow you.
My heart will say yes to your way, Lord. Whatever it takes. Because you're worthy, Lord, I will bless your name, Jesus.
Whatever it takes, I worship you.
His name is Isaac. And God tells him to sacrifice that son, that same son, as a form of worship. And I've heard this story so many times again, but I've always wondered, what was it that gave Abraham the faith to sacrifice what God gave him? What was going on in his mind? What was he thinking about as he was going up Mount Moriah? I can hear him saying, whatever it takes, I worship you. What made Abraham such a great man of faith? Well, it was revealed to me and to all of us in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 18. It says that Abraham concluded that the God that gave him the son Isaac would be the same God to raise Isaac from the dead. So Abraham fell in love with God so much to the point that he knew that God was not a man that he should lie. Neither is he the son of man that he should repent. If he said it was gonna be, then it was gonna be. If he said that through Isaac, I will be the father of all nations, and if that same God is telling me to sacrifice Isaac, that means God must be about to perform a miracle. He must be about to prove to me that he is the resurrection. Now remember, this is before Lazarus. This is all the way in Genesis that Abraham concluded that God cannot lie. I wonder if we can be like Abraham and see the miracle before it even happens. I wonder if we can be like Abraham in the middle of our tears, in the middle of confusion, in the middle of an uphill journey, we can see God making a way and turning things around. You see, Abraham showed us that we don't have to wait till the battle is over, but we can worship God right where we are. Why? Because he's God. Why? Because there's nothing too hard for him. He's Alpha and Omega. So whatever you need, he can be just that. Now, if you feel like Abraham, I want want you to lift up your hands and I want you to cry out with a loud voice. There's nobody like you. There's nobody before you. And I trust you. I believe you say you're
over the building.